United States aircraft carrier Windham Bay arrives in Formosa with a consignment of P-47 fighter planes for the Nationalist government. Department of Defense pictures show official transfer by General Chase to General Wang, chief of the Chinese Air Force. Turning over the planes is particularly significant in the light of President Eisenhower's decision to withdraw the United States 7th Fleet to permit hit-and-run raids by the Nationalists on the Red Mainland. After 4 years of training with American advice and assistance, the Chinese troops proved their mettle in the smart exhibition they put on for Generalissimo Chiang Kai-shek at Taipei, capital of the island stronghold. It is estimated that Chiang has a 500,000 troops, many of whom are veterans of wars against the Reds on the mainland. Weapons and equipment supplied by the United States have welded the Nationalist Army into a formidable striking force. When the strategic moment arrives, these soldiers may be used to create a diversionary movement to draw Red units from Korea. In ever-increasing numbers, refugees from the eastern zone of Berlin stream to the western centers. Sometimes at the rate of 2,000 daily, they make their way from behind the Iron Curtain to face an elaborate screening system before they're shipped further west. Carrying only the meagerest of possessions, they seek the sanctuary of freedom. Their arrival causes a crisis in already overcrowded refugee camps. It has been estimated that one out of every five of West Germany's population is a refugee from the East. For freedom, they willingly take on the role of wanderers. To Rome comes Secretary of State John Foster Dulles, first stop on his 9-day fact-finding tour of Western Europe. Italy's Premier De Gasperi welcomes Mr. Dulles, who will re-examine our foreign aid program in the light of Europe's contributions to its own defenses. Harold Stassen, Mutual Security Administrator, accompanies the State Secretary, whose visit is evidence of the Eisenhower administration's new policy of toughness in the global strategy against communism. Prince Bernhard of Holland is a special guest at services marking the 300th anniversary of the incorporation of New York as a city. The service is held at St. Mark's in the Bowery, oldest church on Manhattan Island. By proclamation of old peg leg Peter Stuyvesant, New Amsterdam, population 800, was incorporated as a Dutch city in 1653, 27 years after Peter Minuit bought the island from the Indians for $24 worth of knickknacks. 3 centuries pass and the city a Dutchman incorporated has grown in size and value. For 200 years, excavation of the fabulous ruins of Pompeii, 20 miles south of Naples, has been proceeding. Almost 2,000 years ago, the Roman resort was buried by an eruption of Mount Vesuvius. Today, a calcified body comes to light, and Pompeii's Forum becomes a mecca for tourists. Stepping stones to accommodate pedestrians during torrential rains again come into their own. Here, buried under 50 feet of lava and volcanic ash, is preserved the playground of the Caesars, with its insignia and even the color of its paints preserved. Here for posterity is revealed almost intact the grandeur of ancient Rome.